In this tutorial, we will explain the PVSYST workspace. The workspace is a folder on your computer's hard drive, which contains all data created and imported by the user. This includes project files, PV components, weather data, etc. By default, the folder is set to C:\users\username\PVSYST7.0_data. But this can be changed. There can be multiple workspaces on a single computer. However, when you start working with PVSYST, you will typically work with the default workspace. The workspace can be found here on the main PVSYST dialog. You can also find it in the main menu File, along with different importing and exporting options. Click on the Manage button to bring up the User Workspace dialog. When files are saved by the user in PVSYST, they will automatically be saved in this folder structure. PV components will be saved to Compose PV, project files will be saved to Projects, etc. If you hover with the mouse over the information icon, you can see a short description of each folder. For a full description of the file organization of the workspace, press F1 to go to the corresponding help page. Exit the help file to return to the workspace dialog. If you click on the location link, you can view this folder structure directly in the Windows File Explorer. The toolbar shows different tools you can use to interact with the workspace. The first four buttons on the left are for selection, as well as expanding and collapsing folders. Then, there are four main actions you can perform with a workspace: switch to another workspace, create a new workspace, import partial or whole workspaces, and export partial or whole workspaces. When starting, you will only need to use a single workspace. The following advanced tools are only necessary when using multiple workspaces. Switch allows you to change to another existing workspace on your computer. We have already created several workspaces for this tutorial. To switch, you must find the new workspace on your computer. In our case, we saved it to the desktop. If you choose a folder that does not yet contain a PVSYST workspace, the program will propose creating a new empty workspace in this folder. You can now see that the location link has changed and the files correspond to a different workspace. You can also create a new, blank workspace anywhere on your computer using this button. Importing workspaces allows you to merge another workspace with your existing workspace. You can import a whole workspace or just some of its contents. While importing, you will still maintain all the existing files in your workspace. It will simply add the files that you are importing to the current workspace. Here is an example of importing a workspace into another one. You can also export workspaces and components. This is useful if you want to move a workspace into another computer or transfer files between workspaces on the same computer. There are three ways to do this. You can export the entire workspace, export selections, and export components. You can either export files and folders directly into another folder or as a zip file. Exporting as a zip file will make it easier to transfer the workspace to another computer. PVSYST will never delete your data. When installing a new version, PVSYST will store your whole workspace as a zip file that you can retrieve if needed. Exporting a workspace will export the entire workspace folder. Exporting a selection will only export the files and folders that are selected in the dialog. Exporting components brings up a new dialog. To get to this dialog, you must first select which folder you want to export to. In this dialog, the left panel represents the current workspace. The panel on the right is the folder where the files will be exported to. To export a file, select it on the left panel and click the Export button. You can also reach this option directly from the main PVSYST dialog by clicking File, Export Components. From this file menu, there is also an option to export projects. Exporting projects should be used when sharing the project with a colleague. This ensures that the files involved in the project are correctly included in the zip file. We have now seen how to manage user data in PVSYST. When beginning with PVSYST, you will likely not need these advanced features. However, it is important for you to understand exactly how your data are handled and stored by PVSYST.